Aloha, I'm Ali'i Carvalho, and this is The First Time. Seeing Moana for the first time was amazing. I remember the first time I saw it, I actually saw it on my producer's laptop. So it was like a very small screen. The animation wasn't finished yet. So like sometimes Moana would like lose her hair or like just the background would completely freeze because they were still working on it. But the first time I saw it with an audience would have to have been premiere night, actually. So I saw it with my family and some of my friends were there and in a theater full of press and Dwayne Johnson's friends and family and a lot of people that I would soon come to know that were in the industry. It was hectic and mind-blowing to kind of like hear everyone's reactions to the things that I was like, oh, I hope people find that funny. And then like it landed and I'm like, oh, this is what it feels like to make a movie, guys. So the first time I met Dwayne was actually at a press shoot and he brought me flowers the first time. And I think we had a photo shoot after that. And I remember very vividly hanging off of his arm because it was like, you know, a good photo. And I remember him smelling very good and him also being very like shiny and just like he glowed. So I remember grabbing onto his arm and being like, wow. What a bicep. That's something weird. But my mom also, the first time my mom met Dwayne The Rock Johnson, she said she went rock climbing and still tells that story to this day. So you tell me which one is more embarrassing. The first time I realized I was gonna be a Disney princess was, after I got Moana, I had to keep it a secret for a while. So my mom and I would, I would often look at her and just kind of whisper like, Mom, like, I'm Moana. And she'd be like, I know, baby, yeah. Like, this is it. We have to keep quiet about it. And you know, even our close family members can't know. But I knew how important it was from the very beginning to have a Polynesian heroine also, and to have someone who was in control of her own story and ventured beyond the reef, beyond what she knew to save her family and to experience the world around her. And like that was, as a young teenager myself, that was so empowering. So I knew from the get-go that I've got to make my family proud and it'll also change my life, and it has. Well, the first time I performed a scene in The Little Mermaid was very different from the first time I watched it. That shit was hard, okay? So I think the first time I rehearsed was actually, besides the music, because I had been rehearsing the music for a good while, but I actually went to Las Vegas to train with Fly By Foy because I had like some aerial work to do. Anyway, hate that. And it was like really hard. I had to like work my abs and I was also singing during the same time that I was like flying with a harness on. Love to explore that shore above. But it was a lot of fun. I gotta say, like, besides the fact that everything hurts when the day is done, like you discover muscles you never had, like it is so freeing to just be on wires and just be like, I'm gonna do a somersault. Like, you're flying in the air. It's very fun. Yes, the first time I met Lin-Manuel was actually over like a FaceTime, I believe. And he was in his Hamilton getup. He was dressed as Alexander Hamilton. He was working on the premiere of that amazing Broadway show, and he was also working on Moana simultaneously. The man is a beast. But I was recording the music that day, and he was like, hi, so I'm in the middle of rehearsals right now, so don't freak. I'm in old colonial wear, but I am here for you, and I can't wait to hear what, you know, how you've practiced. I remember at the first time I sang the song all the way through, like, it wasn't perfect, but he was really sweet, and he said, oh, we're good, we're done, like wrap it up, let's go home. And I was like, okay, please don't do that, but that makes me feel so much better. The first time I read the script for All Together Now, I remember really relating to Amber. She is definitely an optimist. She's someone who always has hope, even in the darkest of times. And yeah, there were a lot of things that really drew me to the project, as well as Brett Haley, actually, the director. I had auditioned for him before for a different film that he was like, not quite right for it, but I'll keep you in mind. And I remember being like, great, I'm never gonna hear from this guy again. But he did keep me in mind. And this is my first live action film. So I'm really, really grateful. And I had the best time.